Welcome to the seventh video in our series, Understanding Inflation and Escalation in Defense Acquisition, Best Practices for Cost Analysis. Today, we will present the concept of cost estimating relationships and how to model them. Let's get started. To discuss cost estimating relationships, or CERs, we need to emphasize the importance of relationships. To start, let's suppose we have many historical programs of varying complexity, represented by the technical parameter weight, and we want to know the relationship between the cost and weight for two programs. Let's take the two programs from 1995 and 2015 as examples. We can begin by isolating the relationship between these two programs. However, because the programs were executed 10 years apart, we need to adjust for the price change that has occurred between them. Much of the existing guidance on normalizing historical costs calls for adjusting for inflation using an inflation index. So let's go ahead and do that. Notice that after these programs are adjusted for inflation, the relationship changes. In this specific instance, we see that the cost of the increasing weight is in fact lower than you might assume using unadjusted costs. This occurs because the 1995 program was further in the past. It gets adjusted further because more inflation occurred relative to the 2015 program. The change between the adjusted and unadjusted relationship becomes more clear when you show the two side by side. In a CER, we attempt to derive the relationship between cost and the technical parameter, in this case, weight, not just between two observations, but for all observations in our dataset. This requires using a regression, or a parametric approach, which essentially creates a best fit line through our observations. In normal circumstances, you cannot perform a regression on the observed then-year dollars because of the price change that occurred. Instead, if we adjust all the observations for inflation using the same inflation index, we will convert our programs into constant year dollars. Constant year dollars is the term used in the Department of Defense to convey that costs were adjusted using an inflation index, not an escalation index. Now we can perform our regression in constant year dollars to derive the inflation-adjusted relationship between cost and weight. However, by converting to constant year dollars, an analyst neglects the effects of real price change. If we adjusted the then-year dollars using an escalation index, normalizing for both inflation and real price change, we would convert our observations into constant prices. Notice how the regression line flattens out? This is because in this case, there is an inverse relationship between weight and time. In other words, observations in the past were lighter than most recent observations. If the opposite were true, we would see the constant price line becomes steeper. Now that we've created our cost and weight relationship, we can apply the model to a future program of a specific weight. If our observations were produced in the base year of the index we used, the difference between the cost estimate using constant year and constant price represents the amount of cost not accounted for due to real price change. Now, if we were to model a second observation at a lighter weight, the CER shows that the difference between the constant year and constant price estimates will be greater. Take a look at the difference between our observation and the new observation side by side. Now we will show you how this is done in Microsoft Excel. In this particular example, we want to develop a cost estimating relationship that will predict the cost of engineering hours for a U.S. Navy ship. We are provided 5 historical data points, and we will assume for simplicity a single cost driver, which is the weight of the ship in long tons. This is a proxy for the total scope in the system, which we hope will directly drive the engineering hours. We have those engineering hours as well. Now we would like to fit a CER directly on the hours themselves, but for the moment, let's assume that we only have the dollars and not the hours. So first we're going to recreate our historical observations for the then-year cost. As you can see, we already have an inflation and escalation table that runs from 1990, the year of our first historical data point, all the way up through 2018, which is the current year in which we would like to estimate our new system. And you'll see in column D, we have the escalation index, which assumes a 4% growth per annum, and our inflation index assumes a slower growth rate of only 2% per annum. You will also see in current year terms, we have an engineering labor rate of $100 per hour. Back in 1990, that was equivalent to $33.35. First, we're going to recreate our historical then-year cost data. I'll make this more straightforward by naming these column headers for the labor rate, escalation index, and inflation index. This will help me later when I use the Excel function VLOOKUPS. It will also be helpful to name the table. First, we'll take the engineering hours, which are currently measured in the thousands, and I want to multiply them by the appropriate engineering labor rate to return the total cost, which will also be in the thousands. This will keep my units consistent. I'll simply look up the labor rate in the year 1990, and I'll want to reference the inflation table and the column for observed engineering labor rate. And this is an exact lookup, so I will mark false, and that will give me the 200,000 engineering labor hours dollarized at $33.35 per hour. This comes out to about $6.7 million. Again, we're showing cost here in thousands. We'll copy that down in the column, and now we'll have the engineering cost historically in then-year dollars. Now, I would never want to fit a CER to then-year dollar figures. We would want to normalize first, and what we'll show in this example is the effects of normalizing for inflation only, where we neglect the real price change, and then we will show the preferred method, which is to normalize using escalation. To normalize our historical data into constant year 2018 dollars, we would take our then-year cost and divide it by the respective inflation value. So we'll look up the inflation column. As a sanity check, these numbers below should be increasing relative to the then-year numbers because we are bringing them forward in time, from 1990, 1995, and so forth, to a 2018 dollar. We have now removed the effects of inflation. However, in our scenario, we know that the engineering labor rates have actually escalated at double the rate of inflation, at 4% per annum instead of 2%. So what we would really like to do when developing our CER is to normalize then-year costs into constant prices. To do this, we will take that same lookup formula and apply it to the escalation column instead of the inflation column. We will then return the more appropriately normalized values here in constant prices. You can see that this is displayed as the green data series. Now, I want to fit the CER to the data. In the graph below, the constant year figures accounting for inflation alone are here in red. If I right-click on this data point and select Add Treadline, Excel can provide us with a linear regression output. We can show you how to calculate this a little bit later. Let's go ahead and create a linear regression for the escalation-adjusted figures in green. You'll notice a perfect relationship in constant prices, so that all the data points lie on this line. However, this typically does not occur in the real world. We designed this model for purposes of illustration. In practice, the data points should be very close to this line, but they won't necessarily be as perfect as our example. To calculate the regression statistics in Excel, we've laid out an area here. First, we'll calculate the constant year regression shown in red using the linest function. We do this by highlighting four cells with our mouse and selecting the equal button. Then we type in linest. It's asking for our known y's, which in this case is our constant year dollars. Then our known x's, which is our single cost driver, the weight in thousands of long tons. And we would like all of the constants here and not force the regression through zero, so we'll put true for the last two parameters. We'll hit Control Shift Enter for our array formula, and that will populate here. You can see that the slope is 2,322, and the intercept is -946.48. These are the exact same figures provided to us in the graph. And now, we'll get the standard errors of those coefficients as well. We can get additional regression statistics, like the F statistic and R square, through that linest function, if you wish to do so. For the constant price regression, I'm just going to copy that same formula. And now we just need to redirect the dollars, the known Ys, to our constant price figures. Again, press Control, Shift, Enter. And now we have our relationship of $10 million in engineering cost as our intercept, plus a coefficient here of $2 million for the weight cost driver. As promised in the beginning, we're going back and looking at what the regression would have been if we had simply been predicting hours instead of dollars, which is not shown on the graph. So I'm going to take that same regression and redirect the known Ys, not to price, but to the engineering hours, and hit Control, Shift, Enter. This hours model regression predicts 100,000 hours as the constant term, plus a slope of 20 hours times my weight. So those should look very similar to the constant price regression. What you can see is that the constant price regression slope and intercept are essentially the hours model slope and intercept times $100 per hour. And now, to wrap things up. We would like to predict the engineering hours and cost for a new ship that has a specification saying it's going to weigh 16,000 long tons. Our cost driver value is going to be plugged into our various CERs to get a prediction for the engineering for that ship. In this case, the program we're predicting is within the range of the dataset, so it's going back to a smaller size ship, so we'd expect it to be in the middle of our CER. And since our correct CER here in the green is a little bit higher and a little bit flatter than the CER here in the red, we can expect those predictions to differ. So first, we'll look at what our incorrect value would be. So if we want to use the constant year model, which again is in the red, I would take that intercept value, the -946, and I would add it to the slope coefficients of 2,322 times the cost driver of 16. That will predict an engineering cost of $36 million. And if we eyeball that on the graph, we go to 16,000 tons and then look across and it looks about right. However, we can see from the green that we should be significantly higher, so we get that answer here. Now, we're going to pull the intercept of $10 million from the correct regression and add that to the coefficient of 2,000, times our cost driver input, and we get $42 million, which again lines up with the sanity check from the graph, which also looks like $42 million. So just as our engineering cost has escalated, outpacing inflation, we're getting a more accurate estimate here. You can see that if we incorrectly use the inflation normalized data, we would underestimate our cost. Now, going back to the hours model, we observe the coefficient of the hours model were identical to the coefficients of the constant price model. They were just off by a factor of the current labor rate. So we will show that that will give you the same answer. If I apply the hours model, I would say that the intercept of 100,000 engineering hours plus the coefficient of 20 times the driver variable here of weight, 16,000 long tons. Now that's going to give me an answer in hours, so that's 420,000 engineering hours. If I then want to dollarize that, I need to multiply by the current engineering labor rate. When I dollarize those hours appropriately with the 2018 labor rate, I get $42 million, an identical answer to the constant price model using escalation. So this concludes our video 7. When you're developing a cost estimating relationship or a CER, you want to use the constant price figures which have been normalized by an escalation index, and not the constant year dollars which have been normalized with an inflation index. The difference being that the inflation model ignores the real price change we know to have happened over time, and we want to correctly normalize for that to get us the most appropriate CER possible. Thank you for watching. This concludes Video 7 in our series, Understanding Inflation and Escalation in Defense Acquisition, Best Practices for Cost Analysis. For more information or additional resources on how inflation and escalation are used in defense acquisition, please visit our website at cade.osd.mil/policy/inflation.